Hello, everybody. Welcome back to The Read. Today, I'm going to get some of my meditation music on, and this is for Thursday, February 10th. Good morning. Get some of my music on here. Okay, so I do want to say to you, I always light a candle here to set the ambiance, and that might be a little louder than I expected. I don't have my AirPods with me, so apologies. But I lit it, it went out, and then it reignited. So it caught flame in another area of the wick that I didn't see. It really looked like it was out. Even smoke was billowing. And then it reignited. And then the flame just grew and grew and grew and grew. So I do feel like there's a passionate new beginning. Maybe for a connection. You know, I always channel these love readings these days. Or your own passion for creativity is being reignited too. Sorry, I'm just moving something here. Or your own passion for life, for love, for career, for possibility. It's all reigniting. So it's beautiful, okay? So I just wanted to mention that. And as you can see, this light just continues to flicker. It's burning so beautifully. So let's see what we have. I am using, I believe, the Cosmic Dancer Oracle, as you can see here, okay? And let's see what energies we've got. Ooh, two cards came out. I'm gonna grab those. I'm gonna grab one more here. I love when spirit just delivers a hit, you know? Let's get one more message here. It's a pretty big deck. Okay, I'm going to choose one. Choose that. Okay, so we've got Summon the Rain. Ooh, this is a very Ace of Cups sort of energy for me. Also boils down to a number 8, so abundance. I'm seeing that embracing your emotions is going to be a beautiful way forward. Look in the mirror. That's definitely somebody mirroring you in a connection here is what I see. Retreat and recharge. Okay. First of all, gorgeous cards. I am seeing that the upcoming lunation, the full moon in Leo, the way to deal with some of the more intense energies coming up from that lunation is going to be for you to just pull back your energy and just rest. That's going to be the best way forward. Okay. That's what I'm understanding here. And I am seeing that we are at a time where we are embracing our emotions because we're being asked to look at ourselves very deeply here. I am seeing that somebody that you're connected to is mirroring back to you. And whatever's being mirrored back to you is putting you in a very emotional state. That's what I'm understanding here. And look, you can see here, this could be a twin soul connection, a twin flame connection. You can see these two people are mirroring each other. They're connected, separated, but connected still. And the person who's being mirroring you, see, this could be you, this could be someone you're dealing with. And this is the mirror reflection. And the mirror reflection is bringing a wealth of knowledge, of connectivity, of cosmic energy to this person. This person just may not have been receptive. And it looks like this person is being summoned from an ocean, which is beautiful too, because that contextualizes the energy of the rain here, okay? So rain is emotion. And with the male figure here, I'm seeing that this is a masculine energy stepping into their feminine energy. This message has been consistent. So let's see what we've got to pull here. I'm going to pull my sacred lovers oracle, sorry. I'm going to pull some Rider-Waite tarot here. What do I need to know for today? And I just want to remind you guys, as much as this is a daily reading, and I do have a date here, it's just really to signify for those, you know, loyal followers of the channel that I do have something up for them to see, unique to this day. But these energies are flexible. Remember, energies travel. So whenever you come across this message, something resonates for you, it's yours. Lovers, Queen of Swords. Ooh. Eight of Swords. You saw that card fly over here, right? Hierophant. I am getting a decision. Look, another twin flame confirmation for me here. But a soul connection. And a new opportunity forward. A new... Ooh, these are gorgeous cards. Got these. So... I'm specifically seeing that the male figure that I am picking up, or the male energy that I am picking up, somebody here was cut off from their emotions. And I just don't want to say to love. They were cut off from their emotions, period. I mean, if they were feeling emotional regarding a stressful situation, then they dipped into anger and resentment. If they were being mirrored something back to them that they didn't want to understand about themselves, then they just cut off that person, because I'm seeing something was cut off. Someone was cut off. If they were being challenged to, you know, really summon the rain of their past and really understand their emotions better, then they just retreated and they never bothered. They just withdrew and they left. So I'm seeing that this person has dealt with situations in multiple toxic ways because they just didn't want to acknowledge their emotions. But now there's no choice. They have no choice but to acknowledge their emotions because something is being mirrored back to them in a big way. If this is a person you're connected to, I'm seeing that they cut you off because they did not want to work hard towards their ascension. They just didn't make the choice to work towards their healing. But now, that was, you were mirroring something back to them is what I'm trying to say, okay? Something very profound, something very deep. They did not want to work on it at that time. So they retreated and they recharged from you. What I'm seeing now is that the universe has now brought about a tower moment, so to say, or a divine moment that is now forcing this person to acknowledge some of the emotions they buried. This opportunity could be coming back to them because somebody else is mirroring back to them what they were trying to avoid in you. Does that make sense? So this could be another third-party karmic connection. It could be another relationship. It could be their mother, father, their brother, their sister, their cousin, whoever it is. They've encountered somebody else who's been quite cut off to them, and now it's like they're getting a taste of their own medicine. I hate saying it that way because I don't want you to think the universe is punishing this person, but they are bringing in a very divinely guided moment that they cannot ignore anymore. It's just there. I also feel that this person is so distraught that they've walked away from this opportunity too, that they didn't make the choice to move forward. They make the choice to walk away. They don't like that. But then what I'm also getting from the cards is that they're now finally coming to a moment where they're going to make a choice to walk towards you or this connection. They're still going to be somewhat cut off from the depth of this connection, but they are showing willingness to move forward and they're going to work hard at it. The cut off from the depth of the connection isn't necessarily a refusal of the connection or a refusal of you or a lack or a desire of wanting to heal. Sorry, I had to take a sip of water. They want to heal. But what's happening here is that they just might not be as aware or as spiritually evolved as you. This ascension is coming in here for a process because this energy is going to now filter into this masculine's, you know, life. And they're going to start understanding what it is that they need to walk towards. They know they want you in their life is what I'm seeing here. And they're going to work hard at it. Now, this decision of theirs for you watching this video is an opportunity for you to move forward and away from the pain and toward the bigger picture and the opportunity here. You're going to have to really decide. So this decision is for you too. The other message I'm getting here is that don't choose to be cut off to their ascension. That doesn't mean you need to overgive and welcome it either. Just be open to what the universe has to bring you because they're bringing in something beautiful. But they're bringing in something beautiful if you tap into your healing and not into the past. Because if you tap into the past, you're going to cut yourself off from this entire journey. In essence, doing the same thing they did. But there's a beautiful way forward here. So I want to, that's what is coming to you. I do want to see what the new opportunity here is to move forward and see the big picture. Because this is what I want to really channel. Let's understand. Ooh, ooh. Okay, this is nice. Three of Swords, Five of Swords, Ace of Cups. You're being asked to walk away from the past. Absolutely. The past being the heartbreak. And you're also being asked to dip into compassion and forgiveness in order to allow this to come forward. With two Aces here, I'm seeing that not only is there a renewal in feeling, but now there's a renewal and how you want to create this and how this person wants to create this with you too. This could start off as a friendship. Either way, you're being asked to walk away from the past heartbreak in order to welcome the newness in. You, in particular, just have to kind of give up on fights that are not worth fighting for. You have to really choose where you want to invest yourself. Just look at this flame flicker. You've also chosen to really tap into the energies of self-love in order to really move away from this heartbreak. You are so rock solid here is what I'm seeing. Just the temptation to go back into the past may be big. This person can come in with some gaslit ways. This person can maybe say some things that trigger you. But ultimately, just tap into your healing and you'll have a way forward. I'm also seeing here with swords cards, three of swords, five of swords, that don't let your thoughts get the best of you. You don't want to do that, okay? You may have had lack mentality around love. You may have had lack mentality around connections. You may feel that walking away is losing or walking away is showing weakness. Don't think of it that way. Choosing to walk away from something is actually making a very choice, healing decision to not invest your energy in something that you know isn't going to return something to you or that you know isn't going to bring you happiness and fruition, okay? That's how you're being asked to move forward. See what else I need to know. Fool. My God, this just screams new opportunity all across the board. This was sticking out. Tower. Four of Cups. Okay. The Fool. Two of Cups. Tower. A beautiful partnership and union is possible. Look at the Caduceus up here. With the Lion showing strength and protection with the universe, guiding this couple together. Whatever has happened has been divinely guided, okay? You may not have believed it at the time. You may have been super triggered and emotional about what occurred, but it's actually bringing you two back together in a very beautiful way, okay? The Tower of this reconnection is basically bringing you choice. I do feel that there will be a part of you, the person watching this video, who may not want to make a choice. You might be so happy doing what you're doing and moving on that you're just kind of peeved and annoyed that the situation has come up again. Okay? Or maybe there's somebody else in the picture. But the only way to make choices that move you towards new opportunities is by tapping into compassion and love, not into the past heartbreak. And choosing where to invest your energy. But what I'm also seeing here is that the universe is giving you an opportunity to choose this. What I'm also getting here is that you don't need to choose right away. Listen to the divine guidance. Sometimes divine guidance just doesn't come to you in the moment. It plays out. So be open to this person coming back around. See, study, hear, observe what's happening. Also, see, study, observe what's happening to you when this person comes back around. Maybe you're not going to have a triggered reaction. Maybe you're actually going to be quite nonchalant and open to this guy or girl. I'm seeing that if you make a choice right away, you'll be extremely reactive. You're actually not open to this at all. You're just dipping into your wounds. The true thing is to just be open to how this is playing out without any expectation and continuing to move down your life anyways. Because it's in doing that, that it becomes clear to you how this can move forward. I am seeing that your person is exercising a lot of forgiveness for self because they're not necessarily happy with the way things happened. They are acknowledging their wrongdoings here is what I see with these cards too. But I'm also seeing that they're still quite resistant to change. They don't like change. They want to heal, but they just don't like the change that's coming about from it. And that's a very pentacle energy. It's a very 3D energy where they're just really concerned about what that means for their 3D world. But give them time. They will get there. These cards prove it. This person coming back into your life, though, is going to shake things up. I think it's going to test your healing. Okay? That's what I have here for you today. Let me know how this resonates.